Hey folks, welcome to my channel, where I show a lot of different self-built projects. Today I have a small ITX PC build for you. It's a quite powerful gaming PC slash workstation, and it didn't cost me much because I built it myself. Now let me show you the parts I use for this build. This is the CPU, and this is the memory. And that's also memory but RAM. And we have a GPU that is quite powerful. I bought it second hand and it came in this box. But it's actually not the ITX but the XT version. That's the motherboard which you should not throw around like this. Power supply 1000 watt. That's the CPU cooler and it's a new release so nobody knows if it's any good yet. And I tried to get all of that stuff into this small case. So, that is how it looks. And from this side it's just white. But it has this nice big grill in the front. And also some of the battery USB connectors at the top. Also in the front, there is this massive 180mm fan. That can also look like a rainbow tornado. If you like that. I do. The case have a volume of about 30 liters, so it's not the smallest ITX case but still smaller than most regular gaming rigs, whatever that means. The build quality of the case is very good, and here on top it fits a regular sized power supply. Before I start building, I take the power supply, I plug it in and switch it on, and then I touch it. I do that to ground the static electricity so I don't damage any components while building. This is the motherboard I chose. It's from Gigabyte, only have 2 RAM slots as usual for ITX. And it comes with the AM5 socket. And on that socket goes the CPU, which is in my case the 7800X3D. I got it very cheap from Aliexpress. The RAM I use is 32GB at 5600Hz. I found them secondhand. And they go there. That is the SSD I use. And we will need this here in a second. Here it says it's fast. That's good. There is only one M.2 socket on this board. So we plug it in there. And we use this screw that came with the motherboard to mount it down. So this is how it looks installed. Now to the experimental cooler no one knows about yet. It's from Deep Cool and it's quite a big sandwich. And I will do some upgrades to it, but that's something for another video. To get it on my motherboard, I had to remove those pre-installed brackets. And use the standoffs included with the cooler. And those brackets get on top of them, yeah, like that. And some more screws looking like that, to tighten everything up. First by hand, but then also with a screwdriver. Now I have to get to these screws, and the fan is in the way. So I unclip it. And now you can see, we have access from the top to the screws down there. And now would be the time to use some thermal grease on the CPU. But before I do this, I want to check the clearance on the RAM first. That looks okay. So back to greasing. In the meantime, I found that thermal compound that came with the cooler. And I spread it very unevenly on the CPU. Quite sure you can do a better job on that. Ooh, this looks nice. Shiny! You will also need something like this or a very long screwdriver. That one helped me a lot on this build. Now I alternate between the two screws to push down the cooler evenly onto the CPU. I link most of the products I use in my videos in the description. So if you search something, you will probably find it there. You could now fit the fan back in there, but I don't do that yet. Because I thought it would be easier to do some cable management first. Before I can mount the whole block in the case, I first have to install this plate. Next, I plug in all the cables that I can find, just because I don't have much room to access all the connectors when it's in the case. For the most part, I use those white cables that I found cheaply on Aliexpress. So this is the USB for the display on the cooler, and I also needed this iRGB splitter cable for rainbow powers. They go in there, and this is the USB for the display. Here is the 24-pin plug for the power, and also this 8-pin plug for some more power to the motherboard. And I used the wrong cable here, which caused me to unscrew the whole motherboard later on and do it all again. So don't use the 6+2-pin plug like I did. Use the 4+4-pin plug instead. That would be the right one. I don't know why it even fitted in there. Anyway, here's the fan splitter cable, and it's quite a mess with all of these cables coming from the cooler. So I zip tied them together and wrapped them in this white sleeve. Now I can mount that brick into the case, which was easy on the bottom screws but more complicated on the top ones. So I had to use these pliers, because I can't really reach in there with my fingers, and also to screw it in with the screwdriver, it was a bit tricky. Also at this last screw I had to unplug the CPU fan connector and get it in from the side. And with the extended screwdriver, it was possible to tighten it, and then plugging the connector back in again. Now the power supply can be fitted from the top. Until now I touched it every now and then, to not damage any component by static electricity, like I showed earlier. Now graphics card. And that's the kind of cable that goes in there. This time, the 6+2 cable is the right one. First, I have to unscrew these plates here, where the graphics card will go. My graphics card, which is the 7900 XT, uses two slots. Get rid of that, plug it in, and we can use the same screws again to tighten it down. Looking good. That's a bracket that was pre-installed on my case. I did not plan to use it, but I then found this old hard drive from my first PC I built from 13 years ago. The cables to connect it came within the box of my power supply. These are the screws needed for mounting it. Screwing it in, it is rubber mounted for vibration dampening, which is also nice. I'm very happy with the case, it have all the features I need, and it's cool that even this hardware is included to reuse my very old hard drive. I did not plan to do that, but 1 TB more storage for free, I take it. Now it should get in there, but there are so many cables everywhere, so I first have to cable manage this mess, at least a little bit, so the lid can close again. That is good enough. Then the same on this side, the case offers a good amount of Velcro straps everywhere, and I'm sure you could make it look better than I did, but my goal is just to get the big plate on again. And if you think my voiceover sounds very improvised, it's because I do that the first time. Please let me know in the comments if you liked it that way. There goes the dust filter and the grill in the front, which is made from plastic. But nevertheless, I like the look of it. And we are ready. At least ready to install the operating system. To do so, we need to cable it up with the monitor and the keyboard. We don't need the Wi-Fi antennas, but the internet cable to connect it with the internets. And I use this USB stick to flash Windows 11 on it. After that, let's see if it does come to life, or explode in a ball of fire. Nope, no fire. Just rainbows and much power for gaming. The graphics card is very powerful, and also the processor is made for gaming. But it also handles video editing very well, and when I do some 3D modeling, that is also no problemo. The most parts I used are quite high-end, but I did not pay that much, because most of them I buy second-hand or on Aliexpress. And I will link some of the best offers I found down there in the description. I will also do two more videos related to these PC build. One will be a short review and upgrade video about the CPU cooler. And I will also do a video where I share some tips and tricks that helped me to save a lot of money on this build. So subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss that. And if you like the video and give me a thumbs up, that means a lot to me. I know my voiceover sucks, but I swear, next time will be better, and I see you there.